So who remembers what happened last time, my dearest players?
I draw a blank.
That's not good. You should have kept live rounds. And this is the point where someone else goes on and actually says what happened last time. Okay, Cypher, you made the first noise. You're going to you've been voluntold.
But I've been voluntold every time!
Well, you don't have- then don't make the first noise.
I have no fucking clue what was going on last time.
Yeah, you do.
I don't. Only thing I remember is fighting a fucking owlbear.
Okay, so...
You have that? You fought an owlbear?
You fought this strange,
and lots of running.
Creature.
Many heal.
Yeah, you've, this creature that turned into a featureless blue thing.
It worked for the black spider.
And he lives in a blue world with... No.
Not the blue spider, the black spider. Come on.
Let the man continue talking.
Who was the guy we saved?
Gundren Rockseeker.
Rockseeker.
Look, I am aware that the introductory... starter adventure isn't really that interesting when it comes to story, because it's mostly learn the system. It is good at that.
Is it?
Yeah, because you learned, you know the system now, mostly.
Yes, I now have a PhD in D&D 5th.
Exactly. So, when are you going to defend your thesis? I'll be in the jury.
Okay,
you're
so
you failed.
Then after we went from that, and we returned Gundren back to the village, told us to head over to a cave to the west.
Yeah, the Wave Echo Cave, to look for his brothers.
We think we found one of his brothers dead in the beginning.
But later on, you did find several other dead dwarves, so that's not so certain anymore.
Just dwarves in general, okay.
Yeah.
Bought some slimes, and I believe that's all.
Actually, you did look at him, so yeah, that was Gundren's brother, because he gave you a description. That was unfortunately one of his brothers. In fact, that was Thardin.
Oh right, I got those special feeling boots from him. Alright!
Did you already do are you wearing them?
Well, probably, but they won't work until I use them, right?
No, they do work. You just don't know exactly what they do yet.
Oh.
Not because...
Fighting boots.
That's actually... I thought that you were just keeping them to check what they do later. Well,
later on they kind of change into like, ooh, they're nice boots. Yoink.
Yeah, You feel lighter.
Someone been stealing my stuff again.
No, and that's what the boots do. They make you feel lighter.
Roleplay villa.
Oh, sorry. And nobody's stealing your stuff. You're the only one who's stealing stuff here.
You don't know that yet. Much.
I checked my gear.
Yeah, you're missing some weapons.
Yeah, all of them. So, you were in this room, and I think that you actually said that you were going to rest here.
Oh, now hold on a second, who said that?
Because...
remember what happened last time we rested in the middle of a cave of a den of monsters?
Yeah, because I'm holding the D20 of Doom right now.
Wait a minute.
ID.
We don't need to rest. What?
Okay, then we don't rest.
I don't remember everyone saying resting, but okay.
Let me check my
my short rest abilities. Let's see.
I don't
need to rest though.
I'm a copper dragon, so I don't like to rest.
Wait a minute. We already said we rested.
Old stone, but I'm also going to tell because. That's always useful to get a good hook on point again to know where you were. You were in the southern barracks. Well, you don't know that they're the southern ones, but they're the southern ones, trust me. Or don't.
Starfish.
Old stone bunks in orderly rows line the walls of this chamber, and a corroded iron brazier full of old coals stands near the middle of the room. The bones of half a dozen dwarves and orcs lie strewn about, clad in scraps of armor. Well, there were three grey hunched figures that were gnawing at their bones, but you killed those ghouls.
Ghouls.
Yeah, it was pretty ghoul.
We already said that we short rested.
Okay, perhaps.
Because I...
Wait, what?
I have all of my short rest stuff, so I'm assuming
you didn't actually use any.
I used action surge.
Hold on. We didn't do any resting, because I still have my one hit die.
You don't get anything back with a short rest, remember?
No,
well,
I know, but...
the short rest...
Well, I'm not gonna dwell on it right now.
Okay.
So, you find yourself here. What do you do? There's the open door through which you entered, and there's the door on the other side of the room that you can clearly see.
I can investigate the body.
Yeah, suddenly all keyhole holes disappeared.
Fuck you.
Now, actually, I've been thinking about it. Keyholes, unless a door can be locked, they usually don't have keyholes. And in this day and age, not many doors can be locked.
Man, if... It would also be barred with a beam or something if it was...
It'd be really expensive, yeah, just a bar lock.
Yeah.
Well, it's not I'm still gonna ask if there's a key.
Yeah, but it opens.
There's a lock.
I'm assuming that you open... There's no keyhole. And you recognize those tunnels, you've been there before.
Well, you could place your head on the ground, try to look under the door.
Or...
Well, it might work, but you would only be able to see things that are close to the floor, and even then, only with disadvantage to recognize them. Something like that.
Oh, I can see someone's boots. Yep.
Well, that's good enough, then you know that someone's there. Won't work for every door. In fact, these ones are stone doors, so they probably don't have a gap at the bottom, and they're really fucking annoying to open. Yeah, they're made of 6-inch thick slabs of stone with iron handles and hinges. They are low and wide. Perfectly sized for a dwarf. Not so perfectly sized for you, Killen. You have to duck a bit. But you recognize these. This is the maze of tunnels with the numerous intersecting passages that you went through before.
Okay, I guess I'll go back to the cell.
Okay. Well, that's that leads to the same place, but the other side.
Well, yeah, but, I mean, I can go right now, right? Because I went through the left side.
Yeah, that's the right way.
Go die in a fire.
No.
Before I go do my scouting ahead stuff, I should probably do this.
Uh-huh.
I feel like we should explore the northwestern door, because we just... I guess it doesn't really matter too much if it's a big maze.
You see... Wait. Yeah, you see an entrance to the right here, and the tunnel grows dark in the distance, but... Well, yeah, you don't see anything beyond here. The tunnel keeps going. Stealth. Health.
Door.
There's a door there. You find yourself. What the hell was that?
Me signaling the others because they're not following.
I thought you were opening a bottle or something like that. The fizziest bottle ever. So while you're done stealthing, they come clunk, 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 clunk.
And I'll probably
the eastern wall of this chamber has collapsed into a mass of rubble. And to the north, the door stands ajar. Actually it's open.
Oh!
Let me open it already. Well, it's ajar. It's not a door, it's ajar.
I'll peek inside.
Nobody? Okay. And it leads to a good-sized storeroom. Dusty kegs are tucked neatly against the walls, all of them cracked open and split from age.
Hmm. I'll Take a look around? No, that's passive perception. Never mind.
Yeah, the barrels seem very empty, given that the contents have evaporated over the years. This looks like a...
Orvernail.
Well, you don't know what's in it anymore.
No.
But given that this is a these were dwarves here, that is a safe bet.
And...
Oh, you see it open up into a bigger room.
Get back, you! Get back! Remember, you can't see in the dark now, though. You have a fucking torch or hooded
mm-hmm.
lantern.
Oh. Great, wait, give me a second.
Well, scream if you get in trouble.
I bet all of you Dragonborn feel at home here on the side of a mountain.
What does that have to do with Dragonborn?
Yeah, we
Dragons
don't live in
mountains,
we live in cities.
Your passive perception is still 12, Kellen?
Yeah.
Then give me a second.
But your city disappeared.
Wow, they're so exceptionally bad. You hear some shuffling to the right. At steep escarpments divide this large cavern into three sections. High ledges at either end and a lower section in the middle. Carved stone stairs climb up to the ledges. Two large tables stand in the middle of the section, along with a pair of old braziers. A smaller table stands on the eastern ledge. The skeletal remains of dozens of dead warriors, dwarves, gnomes, orcs, and ogres attest to the fierceness of the fighting that took place here long ago. And I just realized that I'm really bad at the definitions of west. That was east. That is west.
Well, I don't know, the map orientation might be different.
Yeah, you hear some shuffling and crunching coming from the west, Gil, as you stand there. You don't see anything, but you hear it.
Okay, I'm going to switch wall and then around the corner.
I'm going to ask you for another stealth.
Okay. Come on, stealth, don't let me down now.
Oh.
That let me down.
Well, maybe it hasn't. It didn't let you down. Remember, in this game it's versus passive perception.
Yeah, and unless they have like a wise person in there, I'm fucked.
Yeah, so...
I mean, if they have like a wise person in there.
Apparently they do not. What do you do? Yeah.
Oh, see if there's anything that's making the sound.
Okay. How are you going to do that exactly?
By peeking around the corner, and if there's
it's
safe, I'll move in closer.
Well, you still hear something, but you don't see anything yet.
Okay, I'm going to basically which corner and then lean against the wall like, I say this like this.
Okay.
And move slowly ahead, but I can't really stay on that, so
okay,
I'm gonna
so
be
you
one
push
higher.
Okay, so you push yourself up against the wall, okay.
Yeah, because it seemed like there was an little hole, or let's say that.
Okay. When you get to about here, you notice that there are some ghouls on the ledge. They're waiting.
I gotta get back and tell the others. Okay, I retreat in the same way I came to this spot.
Okay, feel free. I just move yourself.
Alright. And I wait for the rest to arrive where I am.
Perhaps we should go this way, everybody. It's boring that way.
Enemies over there. I think Nadal will like them because I think they're undead.
Well,
I know
I remember when
I
sent Boko against a couple of ghouls. It didn't go so well.
Why don't we just charge in?
Oh. I'm right ahead. You know what happens if they bite you? Right?
And what happens if they bite you, become a ghoul yourself or what?
Paralyzed.
Oh, they got smashed in the head.
No, paralysis.
Notch my heavy crossbow and I take a few steps forward.
Okay, I want to see a stealth check from you. Nailed it.
Yeah, I don't think they will see him coming.
I put like cloth on my shoes so they don't even crack against the pebbles.
Well, that was kind of a waste because there are no pebbles here, but nice try.
No, mine.
Well, at least your shoes stay clean.
It's a dwarven mine.
Okay.
They are really
clean. Natural all 20 right. And stealth in plain sight. Okay.
That's true, I do have stealth in plain sight. So I'm actually literally invisible to them.
No, you do know the stealth in plain sight.
I have something similar to that.
Yeah, but it's not the same. And
I can attempt to hide in any natural occurrence.
Yeah, that's in the forest.
I know.
Notice how this cave has been hollowed out?
Not natural.
Yeah.
Rocks are natural. I guess you're right. So I
smack upside your head is also natural.
I just kind of like slowly creep forward and I motion for everybody else to come.
Ooh.
I guess I'll take a different approach. So where did I see them, Villa?
You saw them to the west.
Alright, so
are you going to try and flank them or what?
I'm basically going to go around the other way. I'll run our stealth if needed be, but I'll press against the bench if this is high enough and block Scythe.
This ledge is 10 feet high.
Yeah, but I mean this table or something, I don't know. They were at the west.
Just a table.
We'll hide behind it.
Okay.
A little stealth.
Nailed it.
Okay.
Two people are in position.
Alright, well, it's time to draw out the ghouls, isn't it?
Well, you don't really do stealth, so that's easy. Move. There they come. Stop.
A huge scream, I don't know what they sound like.
You hear a crunching from the distance and some very angry creatures coming towards you, though none of you can actually see them as of your position. Thorin, what do you do?
Well, I cannot see them yet.
There is no delay action in the 5th edition.
Yeah, I know, so I just gonna move, I think.
Feel free.
Well, stand next to me, why not?
Yeah, I think this position is nice.
Another.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna stand next to Torin.
Exceptional.
I know.
No, shut up.
I guess I'll just move up by the dragons over there.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, there are dragons.
I fooled you. Kaelin.
I'm going to ready an action to move closer and attack if any of the ghouls charges at the dragons and the tiefling.
Okay.
I think I'm loud.
Yeah, that sounds okay. In a rage from the distance. What kind of speed do they have? You can attack that one if you want. Kill him. That was his entire movement.
If I say no now, can I take it later?
No.
Alright. Okay. Will be pop out. Where's my sheep?
Didn't see you coming.
Oh, advantage?
Yes.
This will trigger sneak attack if it hits.
That hits.
And I don't have any actions, that's right. No, I don't have a bonus action during this round.
You don't have anything but the thing that you just said that you were going to do. Fuck.
That was weird music.
Sylvania!
Combat music?
Which one did Kaelin attack?
Oh, this one is from Dark Souls 3.
Bottom one. I shall strike that one with my heavy crossbow. Phew!
Is the sound that your heavy crossbow makes. As it misses.
And I would like to drop it. Can I also draw one blade after dropping it, or not?
Dropping it isn't an interaction. I am pretty sure.
Okay, so I drop it and then I draw one blade.
That is your 4-1 free interaction.
That's my turn.
Okay. Though, for in the future, I would like you to actually specify what your standard walking around equipment is.
Okay. I said I had my heavy crossbow ready earlier.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter in which order I do these.
Horrifying.
Torin! Now you see them! They're more ghouls! More than you've ever seen in the same place! You feel your XP senses tingling.
So the most what I've seen in one place are 6 ghouls.
7. Oh, right. Well, you're only a level 1. Low. Level low. Sorry, level low. Not 1.
What?
Derp.
1.
I'm half sleeping.
Go back to sleep then. No, wait, never mind.
That wouldn't end very well.
Oh, that's so wrong.
Moving like that increases. He gets an attack of opportunity.
Moving like what?
Yeah, I figured. Moving like that triggers an attack for opportunity.
Yeah, but that's no problem.
Oh?
No, right? I can walk around it.
Like.
No, but I'm just saying.
I moved straight from it. I have 40 movement, so I can walk around this.
You want to
space.
Probably do it like this.
That's why I prefer that you use the space thing, because right now what you did was doing this, and that provokes attacks of opportunities, that's
what
I'm saying.
Well, on Fantasy Grounds you won't have any other chance, because you need to do your movement in parts, and then I need to approve it.
I know.
Thorin, go ahead. Click your buttons.
I'm gonna use my bread weapon.
What was that again? Lime?
Straight up.
Okay, so...
Yeah, that's lime.
Okay. What kind of save?
Dex, right? Dex, I think it is.
Ah, yes. Yeah.
Ooh.
They don't give a fuck.
11. Oh, yeah.
Last time I ever have to endure these roll 20 bugs. So happy. Nadar!
Yeah, I'm gonna move over to here. And I'm gonna do breath weapon.
That's a cone, right?
Go one lower and you can hit all of them.
It's a cone. I can get four of them.
It's a 15 foot cone, right?
Yeah.
You can only hit four of them.
Okay, Nadar, I'm going to tell you something differently because I had the same idea. Do here. That's why.
Yeah, you should have stand
right
there.
Oh, right. Yeah, I'll take that option. Five is better than four.
and you.
Let me warm up my dexterity saves. That's actually
move away,
one too many. Mark,
please.
So there's success, success, fail, fail, success.
Ooh, we took one out.
Oh,
yeah,
the one I attacked.
You put one of them on fire. Exceptional.
They're now easier to kill, exceptional.
Nadar, you should have moved, damn it.
Oh, that's okay. I want to see what happens when they paralyze you, Caden.
Oh, you don't know that yet, but I know that they can't paralyze me.
Yeah, for some reason, elves are immune to it.
I'm gonna...
Only I know that.
Yeah, it's exceptional. You are going to...
I'm gonna use Ray of Frost, but I think I'm gonna use it on the bottommost one on the map, I guess.
Okay. Push the button. Oh, wait, that's enough. Kellen. Also, feel free to narrate your own actions, you know? It's not my job to narrate your actions.
See, can I do this? So as a bonus action, I'm going to disengage. And
wait, disengage first, okay?
Hold on.
Yeah, I know what you're going to do. Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay, do it. If we're gonna put something in call, because it might be better to do this. Not this one.
What are you doing? Oh.
Seeing if I can do a spell properly. No. Deal damage.
You have 30 feet of movement, right?
Yeah. Oh, I could probably stand here and do it.
Actually, you can stand. Here. Oh no. I can't see a way to make that 30.
I'm sorry. I think this is a valid way to do it.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm gonna do. The disengage will still happen, and this is what my cone will be.
Okay. Yeah, it's taking a bit more movement, but you know that.
Yeah, that's what I calculated in. And then it's gonna be a...
Look at her, she's standing on the table. What a show-off.
Oh, for fuck's sake, that's a low roll.
Best roll.
Yeah, but in total, it's 16 damage.
Well, in 10. Potentially. That's...
Two fail.
I see one fail.
Oh, right, 13 is still a success. Never mind. One fail.
So one takes 4 damage. The others take a grand 2 whole damage.
Yeah.
And the crowd goes mild!
That was a bad spell, Jesus.
Well, this one is going to take the opportunity to take a... a snack. I heard that Dragonborn are a delicatessen. A delicacy. See, they are. Wait. That can't be right.
AC 10?
That's incorrect.
What's yeah, something must be wrong. I don't have AC 10.
Your armor class is filled in as 10.
Well, last time it wasn't.
This time it is.
Armor or something?
Yeah, I have to check what kind of armor that I'm wearing, because I'm definitely wearing armor.
And this is why
I'm wearing a chainmail. What's that? What's that?
16. 16. Your armor is 16. I'm pretty sure. Can someone check? Don't use the compendium, because that doesn't say if you actually add AC or not. If you add dex or not. Just use the player's handbook. Sylvania.
Alright, I'm going to run forward while spinning in circles, slashing my blaze at this one. Looks quite silly.
Well, it's almost... It's a bit... It's kind of sort of effective-ish. Half.
Yeah.
This ghoul is going to take a good bite out of Torin. No, sorry, a good claw. But he completely failed at that.
Just a 16 here. No
yep.
Dex added.
Then it's 16.
Because it's heavy armor.
Wow. The one is going to attempt to claw you.
Aha.
There we go. Nada, you take 5 damage, and I would like you to make me a constitution saving throw. Yeah, no problem. Torin.
Yeah, I'm gonna flurry of blow his ass.
I didn't know
you're gonna do it to his ass?
I didn't know you were into that kind of thing. I mean, if you want some privacy, we'll leave you alone for a second.
Suddenly a screen appeared in front of the two, covering sex from everyone.
Well, spankin'.
Ouch.
Ouch.
Okay.
Oh, you will definitely get a job in the Enchanted Forest.
Actually, there's one attack left that goes on the one to the left, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Another. Yeah, that was just too wild for the ghoul. And you've all seen things that you cannot unsee. Give me a will save. No.
No magical screen appeared to cover us from it?
I'm hitting the one right in front of me.
You hit, and you manage to give a nice dent in its skull. Like, unfortunately, you know, it's undead, so it doesn't really need that. Exceptional.
Alright, I think I'm going to try to hit the two by Nadar and Sylvania and the one by Torin with a magic missile.
Okay.
Ooh, spread the damage. Nice.
Helps me out.
2-3-3. I'm going left to right on that. Not that.
Sure.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter for you because you couldn't guess which one would be the highest anyway. Kaelin!
Okay, I'm going to run across the table and attack the one in front of Sylvania.
I'm assuming that you're using a bonus action for that?
Why?
Provocation?
Oh,
right.
Provokes.
Derp! Different system!
I can move freely within their reach.
That is true. One of the
so
things
this
which
will invoke
makes...
sneak attack on the one in front of Sylvania.
Oh yeah, that hits. And you managed to put him in the ground, I think. Well, back in the ground.
And the follow-up attack will go to the one below me, on the other side.
What did you say? Blow me?
I can see where Villa's mind is right now.
Yeah,
10 more minutes and the tentacles come out.
And suddenly
oh, man. Another.
Suddenly, Rain is here.
Another. Remember what you just said. I'm not saying anything more. Sylvania!
Alright. Before the tentacles have a chance to come out, I'm going to slash at the one next to Nadar.
Well, you hit them once. You should really replace that light blade. It sucks.
It's the same exact roll.
Hey, with the short sword, it's really cool. It's more reliable than yours.
Yeah, the ghouls, they are going to do a really ghoul thing. They're going to hit on Torin, because Torin was so nice to show...
Torin with 14 AC?
Well, I don't know if that's correct. Actually, I don't think it is, because he adds... he has 10 plus dex plus whiz, so it's probably higher than that. Let's all have a quick look at Torin and laugh at how his AC is wrong. No, it's actually correct.
Really?
Look who's the fool now, Kaelin. Laughing at someone who's not even wrong.
Well, it's just something weird that he only has 14 when he has dex and
Torin,
wisdom.
You take 8 damage and you're going to have to give me a constitution saving throw.
He does get 3 attacks in one turn. Plus that was like a bonus action.
You go stiff. Ouch. Well, stiffer than you already were, given what you were doing to those ghouls.
God. You're not going to be able to upload this.
Oh, yes I am.
Hey, that's exactly what happened to Boko.
Torin, 8 damage, please. I see your HP is still 21. Still 21. Still 21.
Torin?
Still 21. There we go.
No, it was 13 on my sheet.
Don't do it via the sheet. You need to click on yourself and then just click on the green bubble and change it there. That's easier.
Yeah, it wouldn't show the bubble.
Yeah, then you need to click away and click again until it does, because that's a roll 20 bug. That's been around since forever. And apparently 10 bucks per month from thousands of people is not enough to get it fixed. Hey, did you know I'm fed up with Roll20?
No, we didn't.
Glad to be able to inform you. You are very dodgy, Kellen.
I'm nimble.
Another claw in the face. No, claw nowhere near your face. Torin, you need to give me a constitution saving throw. Yeah, you manage to shake yourself free, but you can deck this turn. Nadar!
Well, I'm gonna bring the hammer down on the one right in front of me.
Let's break it down! Oh!
Oh!
Oh, it's on! Nadar, I'll race you!
Oh, you're on.
Move!
Nadar, you've been requested to move.
Doesn't matter if you...
Yeah, where do you want me to move to?
Closer to the ghouls, so I get the sneak attack from you.
Attack. How's that?
Oh! This! Wasn't that hard?
Technically...
I don't know!
Well, technically he was closer. You didn't specify. That's your fault. Exceptional! Do you have any exceptional ways of ending this combat?
I think he's just gonna use his magic missile again.
I was saying, I don't know about ending the combat. I don't know what HP all these things are at, but... Actually, I think I'm just gonna Ray of Frost the one next to Torin.
That's great.
Frosty, as always.
Toasty!
Your Ray of Frost sucks.
What was that?
Enough to kill it.
Yeah.
Kill him!
Right, so in a... Flurry of Blades... The bottom one gets attacked.
The bottom one gets missed, and then crit.
The sneak attack applies to that attack then.
That's 8 plus 7,
that
is...
Damage.
13? No.
15.
I swear I'm good at math. Sylvania.
I'm going to run and do a front flip over this table next to this creature and then slash at it while in midair.
Yeah, that's why you don't do that in midair.
Yep. You almost hit me. Thanks.
Actually, Kellen, a few of your delicious white locks are floating
to
the ground.
This is the first time I've ever done that, sorry. But you look good with short hair.
Oh, not all of your hair, luckily. Finally, Kellen, flustered by the hair that she's dropping to the floor, manages to not dodge it for once. And then she takes 6 damage and does not have to make a save. Torin! I swear to God, roll 20! Jesus!
Almost, Villa, almost. Just a couple more hours.
You need to click so many times on end of turn, it's not even funny. Well, it is, but not to me. Torin! you can act now. Even though you're not a good actor.
Oh!
Torin! / Alpha.
Oh, sorry, somebody was at the door.
Jesus.
You got loud all of a sudden.
No, that was... That's
was
actually
it your pizza?
No. Let's go. Torin,
sure
take your turn.
Yeah. Torin.
I lost my mouse.
What?
Clean your room!
Clean your room, or no Game Boy for the entire week.
No, just dropped under my bed.
That's even worse.
It's wireless, isn't it?
No, it's cable, so it was really easy to find after I found the right cable.
Jesus Christ.
After he found the right cable.
You need to send us a pic of your room after the session, because now I'm imagining like it's worse than Hiroshima on in 1944.
That's
definitely not too soon.
Too soon.
Too fucking soon.
I'm gonna make an exception and say that's too soon.
Don't make me go soon.
Are you all Japanese?
I mean, I have Japanese family members.
I mean, I was being sensitive and not referring to something that happened in September 2001.
Easy there, easy.
Yeah, but that has been 15 years.
Shit happens, and so do disasters.
Yeah.
True, but a lot of people are still very butthurt when it comes up.
Well, not really.
Well, it's mostly because people lied about it.
I kind of hold them the wrong way around.
That's okay.
The spear actually comes first.
Okay. So what are you doing now? One hand or two hand?
I think I switched to one hand because it always was more higher.
Yeah, I switched to one because I always hit it better with one-handed for
except
some reason.
Except now.
Who is paralyzed?
Yeah, nobody. Now the two-hander is start to catch up.
Nobody fails it.
Not the Now he, you get to a new save every round.
Oh, okay. I see it now.
Well, I move over here and I bring the hammer down.
Why are we all standing on the table?
Because it looks cool. Shut up.
Yeah, we're all swashbucklers.
Because we can.
I did it first.
That's really strange, but you'll see why this is a battle song. That's a miss. Exceptional.
I think I'll move a little closer for one.
See, this music is perfect for Exceptional Stern.
And I guess I'll just Ray of Frost this thing.
Okay. You were too fast. You should have waited a few more seconds. Because... Kellen! The Ray of Frost actually hit pretty good. And the dagger does as well. Well.
Oh my god.
It's dead already! It's dead!
I'm fearing it.
It's still right, already dead.
Slash the legs of the table.
What?
Because they're all standing on it.
Oh, you're wrong. You're wrong.
Lucio!
Fuck!
Flat!
But I need 5 minutes, please. I know what's going to happen now.
Okay, 5 minutes. Anyone want some cashew nuts?
No!
Are we taking a 5 minute break?
No. He just needs to do something.
For 5 minutes?
It's not gonna be 5.
Potential snack I could get.
Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna grab a snack real quick.
For some reason, when I first heard this, I started thinking of Fallout.
It's not that old, actually. It's music from the early 60s and 70s.
Yeah.
Because back then, stores in the US weren't allowed to actually play broadcast music. So they all, almost all of them had these, well, these things, these music boxes, basically. So you load a giant-ass cassette in them, because you leased them from a company, and you load a giant-ass cassette in them, and it has like 700 songs on it. And it's all music like this.
And they pretty much just keep repeating it.
Yeah. But because they also keep running overnight, because they don't turn those things off. That's the reason why there's 700 songs. The entire loop lasts 28 hours. Sorry, not 28, 26. So you won't get mad if you work there. Because you always hear it with 2 hours of delay. But that's also the reason why, if you look at these old, particularly Christmas movies from the 70s and 80s, they always have this typical music in stores, because there's always a music scene. There's always a store scene in a Christmas movie.
Be right back.
I'll skip somewhere in the middle.
Back.
Sup?
Peppered salami and garlic cheese.
I'm Beck.
Hello, Beck. So which way do you want to go next? Because you have three options. You can go east, go north, or of course you can go west!
I wanted to go up!
Technically we could go south.
Yeah,
the random southern pieces we haven't went to yet.
It can always go south pretty easy, even if you go north.
That's true.
I hope we let Caitlin scout ahead.
Which could totally make south a better option.
No, that's not scouting.
At least we
ahead.
Vaguely know what's in that direction.
Yeah, if we go south, it has less chance of going south.
Exactly.
Yeah, but it's kind of like the coward's choice. So if it does go south, we
and it would be terribly
north.
Boring.
Well, if you take too long, I'm going to start removing enemies because.
Well, I'd say Galen picks the direction, and we'll just see which direction she scouts in.
Yeah, we pretty much all just follow her at this point.
Although
Does experience even really matter?
It does.
Oh. Can it carry over?
It will.
Awesome.
Well, it doesn't really matter because whatever you do, you're going to be stuck at exactly 2,700 at the start of the next campaign.
Okay.
AKA, you're going to level up to level 4 and then the next campaign starts.
I'm probably going to switch to one-handed.
Oh, that's easy. I'll make that easy on you. You'll see why.
Alright.
I'm late, I know.
You're late!
Well, you had nice, soothing, relaxing waiting music to wait. To listen to, I mean.
Go ahead. Kellen, they've been waiting for you to scout. Or actually, maybe you want to heal a bit, because I know that you all have some... Yeah, you need to roll also. 2d4 plus 2.
Do you take damage and you roll 2 ones?
No.
Man, I didn't feel that well.
Come on.
It's a 1 out of 16.
Come on. Well, that's better. You are incapable of rolling two different dice. Oh, right, Nada, since you weren't there last session, they all had the chance to buy potions, so I spent all of your money to get potions as well.
What, all of my money?
Basically. Like, there's nothing else you can buy with it, really.
Well, that's a good idea, also take a potion.
Yeah, I'll take a potion as well.
I recognize
since this. I paid for it.
Well, yeah, that leads to the maze. Right? However, you haven't fully explored the maze. You're quite sure of that. This map is so high resolution that I'm actually zooming out a bit.
You guys want to explore the rest of the maze or want to continue?
How much did the potion heal again? 2d4 plus 2, right?
Yeah, the thing that Kalen just rolled twice.
It's a maze. What if you get lost?
Is this back to that south and going south conversation again?
Yeah.
It's actually pretty doable. Jesus Christ. You guys suck at healing.
No, I did pretty well. I healed exactly what I needed.
Let's take another route. I feel like going back into the maze isn't going to help us.
I overheal myself.
You do know that you have not completely explored the maze.
Hey, you know what we could do? We could retreat, spend a day in the city, and then decide to go into the back entrance.
What back entrance?
This one has no back. Oh God, Steam. Please tell me that the Steam sale hasn't started.
And what are we going to tell Gundren?
I think he's talking about the one at the brothel in town.
No, he's talking about something else.
And what are we going to tell Gundren if all of his brothers are dead because we take a day?
I don't start yet, Zilla.
Whew, good. My wallet is
trembling. I
just used
a potion, by the way.
Fine.
Wait, now is the chance.
Mark it off.
Top or south?
Oh.
If you can't decide, I will roll a d2 for you to decide.
East.
That was not an option.
We came from south.
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 We came from south.
The dice have
spoken.
The gold
coin has spoken!
Oh my god.
I'm assuming that you picked that gold coin back up?
Oh yeah, it's right, not even
well,
leaving my
I'm
hands.
I'm running with you, because this is...
Running! Oh god.
Over this way.
Yeah, you've been there. You're being followed by Kenji. I'll just make a pile of player.
A player compilation.
Yeah, Scalen?
Huh?
Wait, let me ping everyone so that everyone's still... You haven't seen this one yet. Because you see... Well, you hear water in the distance. And I don't mean the crashing wave that you hear every 2 minutes or so.
More like a whooshing sound of water that's continuously coming down.
Mm-hmm. Kellen. A still pool fills much of this cavern. The water is dark, revealing little of what might lie within. The shore of the pool consists of a thin layer of broken shells from strange, pale mussels. Mussels, not niet spieren, mussels. And a fishy odor hangs in the air. A passage leads south from this area, and a set of steps climbs up to the east. A sluggish stream flows out of the cave to the northeast.
Okay, I press against the wall again and do my usual slowly and steadily advancing.
Okay.
I'll take another peek around the corner over here. I signal the others to come again, to come closer.
Yeah, you have a way north and a door. The signal was given to come closer, guys. Suddenly, everyone hears you, and you are being rushed by 700 ghouls, and you die.
What?
No. Kellen, snap to the grids, please.
Oh, sorry.
You suddenly feel yourself being forced into a nice square.
I look into the water.
It's black.
Well, the water is dark, so you can't really see through it. What do you want to do?
I kind of kneel down and I look closely at the water. Does it look like unnaturally dark, or...?
No.
Okay, then I put my hand in it and kind of like feel around.
Acid.
Next to the... You don't necessarily feel anything on the floor. It starts shallow, and you quickly feel it going to 10 feet deep. Well, you can't tell that it's 10 feet because your arms aren't 10 feet, but it's 10 feet deep.
Alright. It's over this way.
That's a little pool. That's not actually that deep. This part is only 3 foot deep.
Whoosh.
Splash, splash.
Where?
Can I edge around the side here?
Wait.
Yeah, you can, and it goes, the stream continues north.
Never split up the party, and look what they're doing now. Splitting up the party.
You better turn back, since that doesn't seem to go anywhere.
It does go somewhere. It goes underneath. It ends up here.
Well, Sylvania, you can't look inside the pool.
Everybody, I found something.
You feel it sloping down. I mean, there's a monster in there, definitely.
I found something, guys.
The
we should check it out.
Of the Forgotten Realms.
There could be some cool treasure in here, or perhaps somebody hiding.
I know that doesn't work, but everyone gets it.
Okay, a pile of players, I guess.
What, again? Why? Oh. One of those,
open sesame.
Oh, it's actually,
I mean, because of the fog of war.
Yeah, there are two things crossing over each other. I'll move you to the other side.
Go from the other side.
Well,
stop moving!
Swish, swish.
Stop, Kellen. Cop, stop, immediately.
Here?
One step forward. Can me a second. A wide rift fills the eastern half of this cavern. A stream pours out of the west wall, then tumbles down into the rift and flows out again to the north. Several ropes are secured to iron stakes along the western edge of the rift. And as soon as you show your face, you see that there's a drow elf there.
Fuck.
And
are you saying be right back 30 minutes?
No. I'm saying that's how long my hunger will last before my pizza arrives.
Oh.
Don't starve, real life edition.
Man, can you order me a pizza as well? Dorpedestraat 60? Oh, wait.
Alright, let's move along, or...
I don't think it'll follow the 30 minutes rule, Villa.
Oops. Holding us up. Oh, combat.
That's what's holding us up.
You don't know about us, you don't know about us. Kellen, you've been seen, what do you do? He goes, well, what do we have here? Get him, boys!
Well, okay, so it's 30 feet, this way. Oh, no way, that's not. Yes, that is.
Boom! Take the lead!
Is the water rough terrain?
Oh yeah, it is.
It's not. Really?
Of course it is. You're wading through it.
Bonus action, I take a run action.
Splash, 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 splash.
Ah! Oh, oh fuck!
And then you see that there's more than just the doggy cow. They were literally both just out of your vision. I loved it.
At least we're all kind of bunched up together in turn order so we can run in there.
And then, I'd like to ready that if any of my allies engage with this Drag Elf, I attack.
Okay. Torin! He smirks.
This will probably not help.
And he cracks his knuckles.
Screw
it. How did you do that with the line again? That he's with the multiple
base
corners?
You drag your character, and every time you reach a waypoint, you press space.
Instead of letting go, you press space.
No. You don't let go until you reach the end. And every time you reach a point where you want to change direction, you press space.
I cannot loop past here.
Alright.
That's the issue.
Wait, let me... make sure... Don't abuse it. For now, I'm going to switch off only update on drop. Now you can. Torin, now you can. What's that click, click, click?
I don't know. Heard as well.
It's really easy! Jeez, how can it be so hard? Click your character. Keep the mouse down. Don't let go. Drag it to where you want to have your first waypoint. Press space. A dot appears on the map. Keep going. Like that!
How much feet was that? Because I was just looking away.
40. And
that's then double move.
Yeah, you needed
no,
to double. No, it's difficult terrain.
I have 40 feet movement.
Yeah, but the water is difficult terrain. Have you ever tried running through a 3 feet deep water? That's like a meter deep, right?
Oh, right, and I can only move 20 without...
Yeah, you use two double movement. And, Kellen, go ahead.
Well, if he keeps doing that, if he doesn't, it's not going to trigger.
He already did it, so it triggers.
Okay, then. Ah!
You suck, he says.
Yes.
That is what he says.
Hey!
So difficult terrain is
Sylvania.
Twice as hard to move through?
Yeah, it shows double.
Okay, so I get 52.5 feet for running. So
what? 52? What?
Is 35 feet of movement? What?
That's my turn.
Yeah.
Ah, another chance.
Yeah, because in heavy armor, it's times 3 for running.
Not
the... Divided by 2, 52.5.
That's Pathfinder. Okay, that's Pathfinder rules.
Can you still attack after you run?
What did you say, Nodder?
Can you still attack after you run?
Nope.
Nope, because you used your action.
Printing is your movement.
In that case, I'm gonna take it slow for now.
Yeah, just to take 2 movement actions. You can still do that, right?
Well, yeah, that's exactly what it does.
That's basically what the run is. You convert your action into movement.
See, that's a problem. Now I don't know how much that exactly was. Let me see. What's your movement is 40, right? You can make it to here.
30. And with diagonal movements, I can make it exactly to there. Nope.
Exceptional. Oh no, sorry. It's not your turn yet. Right. As I said, he was cracking his knuckles.
Well, there's 3 of them, which is about to use. You should hit the dragon. He's been saying bad things about you. Aww.
Smack. And miss. He almost dislocates your jaw.
Who?
You, Kellen.
It's a monk. Maybe you should go back to your fists as well, Tolvin. That guy hurt.
There's one, runs up to you and he goes like, okay, boss. In a language that you don't understand, but someone can. I forgot who.
Optional can hear in the distance. Okay, boss.
And he's going to try and crack
was
your skull.
Was it in Goblin? What?
Yeah, it was in Goblin. He's going to try and crack your skull with his gigantic Morning Star.
Well, there goes the death.
Speaking of cracking of skulls. 8. Oh!
That's
a skull cracker. That's down.
Well, the dice has spoken. Sorry.
2d8?
Ow.
Campaign over.
Wait, 2d8?
Bad.
He's very strong. So you're at 0, and you go down. Flap, down.
Where's your fairy in a bottle when you need it?
Exceptional.
Oh god, I'm in water.
No, you're not.
Not
you're
really.
Just out of water.
Well, I have to move first so I can see.
Yes, you do indeed. But you can get vision with just the 15 foot. Now you should be able to see. Yeah, you can see. You can see everything, in fact. Well, all of the relevant things.
Yeah, pretty much. I'm gonna try to magic missile the, I said that's drow.
Oh yeah, look at it.
Black spider.
Nice.
Oh, you must mistake me for my boss.
Is it? Everybody that we meet is just gonna look more epic than the last. Who's the real black spider?
They are all the Black Spider.
And everyone is the Black Spider. Nobody is the Black Spider.
There is a... You can probably guess that the Black Spider is going to have actual spiders.
I'm gonna be a spider. I thought it was just... You know, it's just some punk, you know? Because it's like the first low-level campaign.
You hear a heavy splashing. Wait, that's... As something climbs up the rope and throws a javelin in your face, Sylvania.
is now. I use Kaelin's body to block it.
Okay, Kaelin, you take one. No.
Oh. I hope they now understand the urgency of death saves.
Oh yeah, they shoot. 5 damage, Sylvania.
Okay.
That's 15... 25... Exactly 30.
Mm-hmm.
And then a javelin gets thrown at your face, Thorin.
I use deflect arrows to...
it misses.
Then I don't use deflect arrows.
Kaelin, first death save, please. That's a success. Remember, a 10 is a success. It's slightly more likely to make it than to fail it. Thorin.
Kill it.
Yeah. I'm gonna spend the key and use my flurry of blows again.
By the way, exceptional. Aren't you almost out of spells? Oh no. Oh yeah, you are. You have one left.
Oh, and I used my spear two-handed this time.
Watch. Oh. Whoa. Keep going. Yeah, you do.
Blow the spear up his ass.
That's,
I did not want that mental image, Sylvania.
I'm gonna say he has to make, a strength save or be pushed away 15 feet. Because of my flurry of blows.
Is that a thing?
I still have 2 level 1 and 2 level 2 spells.
You're gonna knock him off the cliff?
That's not what it says.
That was the ID.
I see you have 1 level 1 spell and 0 level 2 spells left. On my screen.
That's odd. No, I got a bunch of them back last session.
Well, that's what it says on my screen. It says you used 3 out of 4 first level spells and 2 out of 2 second level spells.
Yeah, what does it say on roll 20?
Oh, no, I'm probably using that backward then, because I'm just taking them off. That
should have
been how many I had left.
That's impossible to
tell. No, I just spent the third one, or the... Yeah, it should say 2 now.
But you already used 2.
That's what I'm saying, I should still have 2 left. I was still full after the end of last session.
You used 2 in the fight against the ghouls, and then 1 more here, you have 1 left.
Did I use 2 magic missiles against the ghouls?
Yes.
Yes.
I must have forgot to take that one off then, I'm sorry.
That's fine. I'm just reminding you.
Wait, you used a ray of frost, a magic missile.
I think I only did 1.
I think that was it.
Fuck.
You didn't use 2 magic missiles, you used a ray of frost and a magic missile.
Yeah, because you split that magic missile into 3 pieces and then a ray of frost was shot.
Let's see, 1 magic missile. Scroll up. 2 magic missile.
Okay.
No, you're right.
I remembered.
You're right.
Yeah, I forgot. I don't have Mississippi. I forgot
it's 2
realms.
It's just 2. Thorin. Oh yeah, you already did your thing.
Yeah, only it still needs to make a strength save if my flurry of blow attacks hits.
It does. As you crunch his nose, some purple blood comes out.
The strength save is pushed back 15 feet.
15.
Okay, I'm expecting that succeeds.
Yeah, that succeeds.
Sylvania.
Alright. I'm going to fainting attack his ass. So.
Meanwhile, Kaelin is taking a nice bath.
Yeah. Does that hit?
It does.
Alright, add this damage to it. So 12 damage total from that, and then the offhand attack.
You can't do that. Remember, faint attack is a bonus.
Oh, you're right.
But it's still better than a second attack because you don't to roll a d8.
Okay.
Actually, we calculate, it's exactly the same, except you only need to...
Do one to hit.
Yeah, it's likelier to hit, but the damage potential is exactly the same.
That's why I'm switching to one hand.
Move over to Kaelin.
What would that change, anyway?
And I lay on hands the shit out of her.
Comes out.
You get 15 hits back.
Did we get... Or did we use his lay on hands in the last session?
No.
No? Okay, then I get 15 back. Cool.
Well, actually, I did use some of his, but not... You also rested in between. I did not use anything in this part. seems like I have a bit of a punch down to do.
Cross out of my face.
It would be realistic that he would just punch you again while you're down.
Unless I feigned it.
Let's see, can you feint not being unconscious anymore?
What would that do? What would that be?
He would have to make an
deception.
A deception.
Deception. And with a minus one on that? Yeah, good luck on that. Nope.
He notices. He knows it's smart to keep one down, so he's going to...
Can't be as bad the second time around.
Basically, he lifts up his boot and he basically stomps down on your face. It's fairly easy to hit you that way. However, you can dodge it. You do.
Oh.
Stay down! Second time.
Wait, also an advantage? Oh right, I'm on the floor.
Yeah, you're on the floor.
Doing the dinosaur.
Oh, just as I was doing fucking...
Ten damage.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
You feel your nose crunch a bit. That's going to need more than a potion to come out. Bugbear is going to move around a bit and give our dearest Dragonborn what for.
No.
He succeeds at that. What? And with a smack, you take 16 damage. Exceptional. It's still your turn. I accidentally skipped you.
So, the one bugbear moved completely out of my sight, didn't he? I guess I'm just gonna try a Ray of Frost on the drow.
I hope I did that correctly, because otherwise you are now level a million.
Level a million.
Let's see, is that enough? So close. A Ray of Frost on the drow?
Yes.
He's pretty cool with that. Looks hurt. This one is going to charge you, Nodar.
Ah, good. That saves me the trouble of walking over.
Yeah, let's see how you talk after you meet this to your face. As he misses.
What face?
This is... He He's going to attempt to javelin you. Again. He picks up the javelin that that fell here as his interaction and attempts to throw it at you, Torin. But he fails. Kellen. Standing up uses 15 feet of your movement. Half your movement.
Does not provoke. Okay,
not on
so
this system.
I stand up. Oh.
He cracks his knuckles again. Get down.
You get down, bitch.
And he goes, okay. Splat. And he turns into a blue creature.
Again. So did both attacks kill him or just the first one?
The first one was enough to kill him.
Okay, then I use the rest of my movement to...
That's... okay.
Bad idea? Yeah. It's a little risky.
Torin! You hit him, by the way.
23? No shit.
I'm gonna hit him back.
Look at his master tactics.
Yeah, master tactics.
So by the way, exceptional. Did you move closer? Because you can't do that, you know. You just barely miss him twice.
I could.
Yeah. Be right back. That's my pizza.
Sylvania.
That should be about right, I think.
Yeah. Run over to here, bounce off of the wall, over this hobgoblin's head.
Torin's going to lose a few scales.
Bugbear's head, and slash with my blades at the one that's right next to me and Torin.
Turn off your advantage.
Oops.
But that's okay, that's a hit. And that's a hit.
No, you should be taking a 10, actually.
Yeah.
I am mean, though. Oh, you'll see how mean I am. Nada!
Yeah, I'm gonna smash the one below me.
Headphones. I can tell that you don't have them on anymore, you know.
Yeah, that's because I'm waiting for my pizza. They have to bring it up.
Ah. Then just keep it with one ear over your other ear. And then the other one off your ear. I mean... not rocket science. This bugbear is going to turn around and take a good, hard look at you, Sylvania. Takes a good, hard look at this Morningstar, and then imagines the possible combinations of those two, and concludes that would make a really good combination. And then he proceeds to combine them.
Home run, motherfucker.
Home run! 11 damage.
I'm going to parry. Oh, this plus dex. Aww. So minus 3 from that.
Minus 3? Oh yeah, times level.
8 damage. Nope. Plus dex.
Oh, plus dex. Mr. Exceptional.
That would be a good time for an exceptional idea.
Yeah, it looks like
yeah,
allies
which one's
are
the
exceptional.
One hitting for 2d8s?
All of them.
Because oh, the all one, three of them are hitting for 2d8?
Yeah, the one that doesn't do a lot of damage is already dead, and he's blue. Double D, double die.
I think I'm going to go with the one between Torn and Sylvania.
Correct. Go ahead.
And I'm going to cast... regular magic missile, I guess.
Okay, the last one. Go ahead. Oh, that was a good one.
No, I should still have one more.
In fact,
I used Ray of Frost last time.
You have 4 damage left that you can send to another one.
Yeah, I'll send to the one... next to Kaylin and Nadar, I guess.
Okay. Well, seeing that someone with a really broken nose is standing next to it, it's going to do the obvious.
On the ground again, and there's some in water. Oh, good.
Oh, yeah.
What was I thinking?
Oh!
Come on!
It's still...
Come on!
It could have only rolled one lower.
Five.
But that's how much...
Then it would still have been up.
Yeah, but it's... Yeah. Something that you should know, Galen is underwater now. That means that death saves don't really apply.
Oh.
Yeah, Nadar might want to grab her or something.
Or feed her a potion before she floats away.
Something.
Luckily it's not not our turn.
I'm going to give suffocating, 1 HP. Oh. Actually, you do use the... There's no difference between just being at 0 HP and being at 0 HP underwater. Except that you cannot go... you cannot stabilize underwater, so you just keep rolling until you get 3 failures.
That's probably a bad time to mention this, but wouldn't a dead body float?
She's not
dead
yet.
Or like a knocked out body?
It would, but that's not defined in the rules, so it doesn't.
He literally has a 1 in 20th chance
probably
of dying.
Probably a good thing.
Welcome to D&D.
He manages to miss the face mace combination.
I'm gonna repost him.
Okay.
Yes.
You already used a reaction.
You're right.
Galen. Make your number.
Do death saves, they reset, right? Or they don't?
Yeah, of course they do.
Just asking.
That's a failure.
Better than a 1.
Torin!
That's me.
What do?
Hey, Kaelin. I think I'm gonna attack the one that keeps throwing spears at me and missing.
Yeah, because if you use an action, you can get to Kaelin, but then you can't feed her a potion. And if you walk away, you're going to... Yeah. Torin, go ahead, do your thing. That's a miss. That's a hit. That's a miss.
Yeah. So, this time I'm gonna make sure you can't use reactions until beginning of my next turn.
Okay. That means he cannot provoke.
No, I cannot provoke.
He cannot take attack. Yeah. Is there an action involved? A save involved? I don't think so.
No, not for that one. That one just is.
Okay, then you can move to where Kaelin is without risking anything. Sylvania.
Right. I'm gonna take a couple of slashes at this bugbear, try to chop his stupid ears off.
I would go for more than the ears. Yeah, that's about what you did, ears.
Not even that. That's pathetic.
Did I hit him?
No, you didn't. You trimmed his nose hair a bit. Nadar!
I'm going to heal the shit out of Kaelin.
How?
With what?
With a pure light wound. With a pure wound.
I'm not.
Well, that's enough, right?
Yeah, it is enough. She has 1 hit point now.
Okay, now the timer starts. You can hold your breath for 1 plus your constitution modifier minutes. which is ridiculously long, to be honest.
Yeah, I was about to say, I was like, that's forever.
2 minutes, that's cool.
Exceptional.
Not I have your, no your way of knowing how much damage these things can take.
You do have none. None at all.
I think I'm just going to Ray of Frost, the one by Kaelin and Nadar again.
Okay, go ahead, click the button. That's a miss. The contemplation of facial restructuring continues on Nadar, but he misses. He's not very good at rebuilding things. That's something else, though, on Sylvania. 6 damage. Yeah, you just got. Yes.
I'm gonna repost it.
Yeah, you used your reaction. Oh no, you
no,
used
that was
it.
Last
you
turn.
Turn. Sorry, yeah, you have a turn.
Okay, so -6 damage, no damage.
You're such a reposter.
Reposting.
Killing.
We're
underwater.
Repost.
How wounded do they look?
Not very.
Right, so I'm going to stand up and emerge.
Surprise, motherfucker.
Do a stab attack while popping out or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, that doesn't give anything, but this applies sneak attack if it hits.
Uh-huh. It does.
Okay.
That is.
Cross, motherfucker!
That was, Okay, where exactly did you stab him? Because that was surprise, motherfucker.
Basically, it went into the stomach and I just kept going up.
Ooh. They're covered in guts. Well, there goes your plan.
Well,
actually,
I
you still have movement. 15 foot of it.
Could get out of the water.
I'm going to use movement to basically fall back down and stand back up. Hopefully that some of the guts washed away.
You are now semi-clean, but some stains will not come out. Torin.
Yeah, only one thing to do now, right? Kill the last one.
That's...
Holy shit, that's what was that? 28 damage?
Rogues are great in D&D.
And you miss. And you miss. Sylvania.
I'm gonna wrap around to this side and then slash at him.
Slashy, slashy.
Roll over here, there we go.
That's a hit. That's a miss.
In confuse. Put down your weapons.
Another.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'm going to help out with the last one.
Okay. Alt. That's a miss. Exceptional. Turns out this is going
grid.
Exceptionally well. He is aligned. Let me see. There, he is aligned.
Woohoo!
Exceptional. Ooh, that's cool. I'm just going to click until the bubbles show up. There they come. It only took me 4 tries this time. Yay! And I'm going to click the end of turn button until it works. Only 6 times. Yay!
Let's see why you have so much trouble with it.
Oh, now, Torin! You get a. You get a smack? Quite a big one, even. 5 damage. Well, that's enough to bring you down. Galen, you see that that Thorin is down.
As Thorin falls to the ground, I charge up. Go for an attack, hold on. Is it my sneak attack?
You are gonna get
Galen, calm down!
Whack!
Jesus!
We're covered in guts again.
God damn it. Back to the pool.
I feed Thorin a healing potion.
He was already dead. Did you have to do that thing with his stomach?
All hail the half-dead assassin!
Just wrong.
Did you know she's wearing the red Tearstone ring?
Thorin, roll for a healing potion.
Oh, come on. Nobody got that?
Of course I got that. I also got,
there. Thorin, 4 HP. You were too slow, so I rolled for you.
I opened my last 2 potions. Well, this one heals me enough.
You're not gonna rest?
We're gonna short rest.
We're gonna rest? Oh, never mind then.
No, you should... I recommend you take a sip before you rest.
Yeah, take a sip of that Sunny D.
You never know if you got another encounter during.
Yeah, RNG could strike, and if you don't have, you don't take at least. If you have 1 HP during that encounter, it could end really badly.
GM then we're really going south.
1d20.
Fine.
Do we need to revive Thorin before the rest, or will he just automatically?
Thorin, you got 4 HP. If anyone wants to spend... the hour spent passes quite uneventfully. There's like the loud dripping, the loud rushing sound here, combined with the crashing waves every few minutes, makes this quite a tense place to rest. But you are on your guard and nothing seems to be coming this way. For now.
Are we taking a short rest?
Yes, a short one. So now you get to spend hit dice.
Okay, spend my 1 hit die. And then I'm gonna pop a potion while I'm at it.
Yeah, feel free to do stuff.
What is the potion?
2d4 plus 2.
I need a macro for that, but I'll do that on Fantasy Grounds.
Yeah, on Fantasy Grounds you can just bind macros to your F1 to F12.
You're right, I do.
The funny thing is, Angel, you had one.
Apparently
you made one for the potion.
Yeah, you actually do. But still, it's 2d4 plus 2, you don't need a macro to roll 2d4 plus 2. It seems that everyone is almost full. Good, ready to go.
It saves clicks and easy to write, so.
Exceptional. I'd like to remind you that you get to recharge 2 spell levels worth of slots. So either 2 level 1 slots or 1 level 2 slot.
Really? The thing on my sheet says half my spells.
No, half your spell. That's not what your sheet says. Let me see what your sheet says. Gore.
For arcane recovery, right? That's what we're talking about?
Yes. Once per day during short rest, recover half your level rounded up worth of levels of spell slots. That's what I said. So, half your level is...
Well, I took 2 level 1s.
Yeah, that's exactly what you get. Okay. You're up and about again. You see there's a gorge to your right. You see 2 tunnels to your right, but Kaelan, you can also see that there's a tunnel here to the north. And that there's a staircase here to the south.
Maybe we should climb down. What do you say?
I say lead the way.
There are actually no ropes on the other side, just ropes on this side.
Okay, well, I'm gonna do this.
Splash, 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 splash. You don't necessarily see anything down there. Oh. Let me see if you do.
Still worth investigating.
Yeah, it's 20 foot deep.
I'd like to loot the bodies.
Nothing of value.
Can I take a closer look at that, the blue creature?
Yeah, you already know what they are. They are doppelgangers.
Doppelgangers?
They can take the form of anything else.
Okay. What's going on over here, Kaelin?
I don't see anything. Let's go down.
It would be terrible if somebody pushed you over the edge here.
Well, I'm climbing down, so good luck pushing me down.
Yeah, you don't necessarily see anything. There's no ropes to climb up on the other side, as I said.
I know. I'm just gonna look around and hope that the rest follows me.
It's 20 foot deep here, and looking around, you don't necessarily see anything of importance. So you can give me a perception check if you wish.
I wish.
Yeah, you...
Yeah, I wish too.
It seems that the stream continues on into the wall here, but it's... You don't know exactly... Well, the stream is 3 foot deep, and you could technically swim through it, but you don't know where it leads up and how long it'll take you. It's completely submerged.
Oh, nice roll.
But for the rest, you don't see anything here.
Well then, let's go back up into the stairs.
And now that you are here, you can see that there's stairs here. And that there's...
I see them over here.
Climb up, and then...
I'm gonna ask for another stealth.
My boots are wet.
Slump, 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 slump. Slump, slump, slump. Give me 1 second. Because I need to change some things. With regard to that stealth check.
I love when the GM says that. Don't you like to do things in silence? Wait.
I have some rolls to make.
Well, I hope the other rolls suck in and I can actually pass through them.
One of these days when Kaelin is sleeping, I'm gonna put squeaky toys on her shoes.
Oh, she'll notice.
Squeak,
it will not happen.
Squeak,
it won't
squeak.
Happen. Probably noticed during the nights of resting that I keep my things well protected and between my arms.
Even your shoes?
Yes! Hey, they could steal those while I'm sleeping.
Kaelin.
Uh-huh.
You hear the...
What's that noise?
You hear the light tapping of spider legs. At least 2. Well, at least 16 spider legs.
Hey, guess what color they're gonna be?
Green.
It smells like boss room.
Fine. I signal everyone closer and say spider legs. Fine then, don't go closer.
Did you say you have spider legs?
Someone responds to it, thank you. Come on guys, get closer, I'm waiting for you.
Guys, get moving. Now please. Come on, tada. If you're not moving, I'm moving you. Okay. Hmm. Looks like a dark room. Well, let's see. Is it dark? Yeah, it's quite dark.
I listen to the other side of the door.
Silence.
Damn bitch! Open! Damn bitch, open.
Why would you open?
I don't know.
Then say no. Jesus. There's no good reason for it to be open.
Well, anyway, I continue if I hear silence and hope that the rest follows me.
Yeah, okay, I can hear it now. Please close the door. I actually didn't check which ones you heard.
My short rest went through. I used a hit die, so I'm down on that.
Galen, you see that in this room there are two spiders hiding here. They're quite big, so hiding is not quite the correct word for it. Six cracked marble pillars line the walls of this hall, at the north end of which stands a 9-foot-tall statue of a dwarf seated on a throne. A mighty stone warhammer across his lap. Large emeralds gleam in the statue's eyes. The dust and debris covering the floor has been swept to one side, and a campsite of sorts now spreads in front of the statue. Half a dozen bedrolls and packs are neatly arranged around a rough-built fire pit. And a wooden table stands on the west side of the room between two pillars.
This is in darkness though, right?
Hey, it is.
None of us could see it.
Galen can, and you can as well, Sylvania.
Oh, okay. That was, like really dark.
I point towards them like, they're over there!
Shall I start combat?
And then, what could possibly...
And then I signal Nothar to go forward. Because he probably doesn't see him.
Well, they heard you coming anyway, Galen, but so combat starts. Torin? You had your chance.
He was closer.
I was over there and I wasn't Torin.
Torin, your turn.
Yeah, I don't see them yet, so I'm just gonna move forward, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Also, I forgot something.
And then I say, I don't see them.
Yes, you do. Okay. Yeah, you do. You just barely see them. They're in the dim light. They look quite big, like this.
Oh yeah, now I see them.
Now that they appeared in the middle of your screen. Well, you look quite edible. And it seems like they're under commands to attack anyone who enters. So it's going to do right that. It crawls over the ceiling and then drops down right onto you. As it tries to bite you, but it misses. It doesn't pierce your scales.
Oh, it's my turn. Sorry, I was responding to someone on Skype.
It isn't. Galen and Sylvania, suddenly you are thrown into a complete darkness. You cannot see anything.
The will save?
No.
Wasn't me.
Sorry, I farted.
Nadar, you can't see anything either. You're in a globe of darkness. You can see your torch that you're holding glowing, but the light simply does not spread away from the tip of the torch.
Alright. In that case, I'm gonna start moving towards the corner of the hallway. And then a little bit further. I just realized I got 30 feet. It's no difficult terrain.
Mm-hmm.
That I can reach, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna smack him. Oh, my sheet isn't appear.
Well, go ahead, smack him. You somehow managed to smack a spider. Sylvania.
I'm gonna finish the rest of the smacking.
Where are you?
I'm right next to Nadar.
Yeah, you managed to smack him a bit.
Smack, smack.
And then from behind the pillar, Sylvania. You see this guy come out.
Didn't we just kill him in the previous cavern?
No, he has a really ugly shit on his face.
I say, oh great, it's another shapeshifter.
No, you must be mistaken. Anyway, I see that my pets will be able to take care of you, and then he yells out, and Neznar. Nice job on that darkness. Now, if you don't terribly mind, I'm going to let them take care of it, okay?
And then he disappears. Not a chance of that, you blue piece of shit.
He disappears. In thin air.
Okay, somebody bring baking powder.
The spider is going to attempt to attack you, Sylvania.
Right.
And he manages to bite you. Just the bite itself. Deals 9 damage, and I would like you to make a constitution saving throw.
I'm going to parry that first.
But it's this, plus two, minus that, so I only take one damage.
And then a constitution save.
Eight.
You feel the poison course, and you take 15 poison damage.
Ooh.
Yeah, that poison is not healthy. It's not healthy at all.
Silva, are you dead, man?
Torin, you are sprung from behind. Oh, actually, what he's going to do is going to... Nah. He's going to spring on you. He's going to attempt to bite you as well. Which he succeeds at, with advantage. Because you didn't see him coming. You take 8 damage, and please give me a, give me a constitution save. Constitution save, Torin. That's a success. Why are you suddenly at 12? You just had to take 8 damage.
I did take 8 damage. I had 12. Yeah. 20.
Okay.
20 minus 8 is 12.
You take 7 poison damage as you feel the poison course through you. Exceptional. You can see nothing through the globe of magical darkness in front of you.
Yeah, that makes things complicated. I don't really want to walk through it not knowing what I'm walking into.
Don't worry, I can heal you.
I think my biggest problem is my character wouldn't know what direction to even walk through it.
To the left.
Yeah.
Just go straight. Go towards where the battle sounds are coming from.
I could only move it to the end of
it
anyway, I'd still be in it.
No, you have 30 foot. Oh yeah, that's actually correct.
I guess I could get out of
no,
it right there.
No, walking through Kaelin is difficult terrain.
That says a lot about the person.
No, that says... Anyway, exceptional. Decide what you're going to do now, please. I'm going to start counting down if you don't. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six. What the hell was that?
Bump into Kaelin.
Oh. You bump into Kaelin. Kaelin, you feel something bump into you. You have no idea
who's
what.
There?
It's just
flash
me.
At it.
Well then, it's time to get out of here.
Yeah, somebody quickly needs to go help Torin. He's in really bad shape.
Yeah, you notice him now. What's that damage? What's that attack? Kill him?
Sorry, push the talk. Here.
Sleep.
Ah, that's a bad roll. Come on.
It has zero effect.
Worst roll ever. Fuck you.
Yeah, if you want to put them to sleep, you gotta hit him.
Torin.
Yeah, I'm gonna use my flurry of blows. What kind of action would be taking a healing potion?
An interaction to take it and an action to use it.
Okay.
So you're not going to be able to do anything else if you take it and use it.
Yeah, then hitting is my best choice, because if they hit me again, I'm dead either way, so...
Wait, when the fuck did that guy above me appear?
He was standing there. You just noticed him by, you know, walking next to him.
That would have changed a lot of things, goddammit. Okay.
You managed to hit the spider... 2 times?
Yeah, the one in front of me.
Well, there is no facing in this system, but I just used the one on the left, because...
Yeah, the one that first attacked me, but missed it. Missed me. The one that I first saw.
Uh-huh. It takes a step back.
Did I hit it?
Yes, and it spits a web at you.
Oh, then it also needs to make a strength save.
Take an attack or opportunity.
Else it will be knocked back 15 feet.
That's something. Would that trigger attack opportunities if it's passed Stratton's Curse?
Only if you move, no, not if you are moved.
Okay.
That is
only
specified.
Your own movement.
You can take an attack as it goes away to spit web at you, but it misses. Torin, you can make an attack.
Oh, then I take attack.
Just click your button, but you miss. This one is going to take a 5-foot step, and he sees you there, and he does not like that. He starts...
There's no 5-foot step, he takes an attack of opportunity from me.
Right, he's just going to stand there, right. Different system. I forget that you can just cast. So he's just going to cast. And 3 small darts appear in his hand, and they all dart straight towards you. Kaelin, straight toward your face. You take 11 damage.
Missiles?
That was a magic missile.
Favored.
Nodar.
Aha, well, I've got a spider right in front of me, so I'm gonna hit it over the head.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm gonna hit it against his head.
Yeah, that's maybe preferable.
Yeah.
Well, you hit his head off. That's what you do. That leaves a disgusting splat.
And
you're covered in
some movement, right?
Yeah, you're covered in green goop.
I'm gonna charge on. Oh. Right? I still get moved. Hmm.
Another, you brush against something.
I do?
Yep.
Can I make an attack roll to spit it in the face?
No. Well, you can attempt to. It's not gonna do anything.
Oh, you can attack twice?
Also, why are you only moving to there and not entirely to Torin?
You mean like this?
Yes, and without alt health.
Sam, wouldn't these creatures have higher reach than normal?
It's not your turn. Oh, wait, sorry, Sylvania, I skipped your turn.
Okay. Walk over here, and
Why don't you go help Kaelin out?
Smash it a couple of times, because I don't see him.
Well, you do. Now you know the fighting. Oh, right, you can see through the globe. Now you do see him over the spider.
Yeah, but I'm already engaged, so. Oh, attack.
Yeah, you managed to hit the spider good.
the itsy bitsy spider.
Oh, it's not itty bitty. Exceptional. You hear someone running past you at a very fast pace.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Whoops. It's going to attempt to use its spinnerets on you again. Well, no, it's going to attempt to bite you, Torin. Because it likes a nice and digested food. Because that's what this venom does. Exceptional. You're still in a globe of magical darkness.
Yeah, step out and go south. That way you're safe.
Or north.
Follow the wall!
Exceptional, do something, please. Come on! Exceptional, take your turn. Okay, you still can do something after that movement.
I know. I think I will... I'm just gonna magic missile the spider that they're all three standing next to, I guess.
Give me a roll me an arcana. Exceptional. Roll me an arcana, please.
I am. Hold on.
Yeah, no. Okay. Go ahead. Which spider?
The one they're all standing next to.
Okay. Galen.
Spellcasting has no downside if you're getting hit while casting, right?
Give me an arcana.
Oh. Okay.
That's a concentration spell. The darkness.
He's concentrating?
Uh-huh. And you can cast other spells, just not concentration spells while concentrating. By the way, this dude looks like this.
Oh, he's concentrating.
You can see the concentration. You can see it by the pixels, which are really large.
Yeah. I would have guessed constipation. But close enough.
Anyway, Kellen, make your turn.
No sneak attack. I'm going to fucking stab the bitch.
Ooh. Look at him go. Did you stab him good?
And then comes a follow-up.
He's stepping real good. But that's two different sources of damage. And the second one catches him off guard and goes... Magical darkness disappears. Torin.
That's me.
This is where you take your turn. Yeah, like that.
Also, maybe do it like this.
The first one is enough to down the spider.
Oh, never mind.
The second one, well, you can move next to the other spider. And continue there.
Bitter spider.
Maybe it's better if you go help out Kaelin.
Or you can move to Kaelin and indeed give an attack on Neznar.
Yeah, maybe that's better.
Okay, feel free to do that. Actually, I'll do it for you because I don't want to wait 5 minutes. Given that you have become available, it has a taste for elves.
Damn your luck.
But it also is not very good at aiming at elves.
Damn your luck.
Well, it sees you coming towards him, Torin, and we'll see. 2 plus 1, that's 3, 4 plus 1, that's... Okay, you're at 0. And you take 2 damage, Kaelin. As he throws magic missiles in your face. Which are surprisingly effective in 5e.
I'm gonna whirl my maul around and smack it in the face. Not so very good.
No, not so very good. Sylvania!
I'm going to second wind and then attack. Then attack.
Okay.
And then I'm going to move over to here.
Oh, where is the other attack?
There is no other attack because I use second wind, which is a bonus action.
Okay, yeah, you miss. I was waiting for the other attack to declare.
Oh, it's alright.
Yeah. You hear in the distance the splashing of water.
Oh, goody.
It's really hard to tell where it's going, of course, but...
Yeah, that's somebody going for reinforcements.
Or someone running away. But it's... apparently he's taking the stream.
It's the actual black spider, goddammit.
Exceptional. Well, of course he's the one that runs away.
Otherwise, how could we face off against him in the next adventure?
And this guy's face looks different, so I'm assuming...
Yeah, he bleeds red. The others bled purple.
We got fucked.
This one bleeds red, the one you're fighting now. So you're pretty sure that's actually a drow. Exceptional, your turn.
Well, you heard the man. Magic missiles are effective here.
Exceptional, could you please take your turn within a minute or so? It's kind of annoying to have to wait 2 minutes every single time. Thank you. To who?
The other guy casting magic missile.
You out-magic missile him. as he drops to the ground, and he does not change into a...
God damn it, I wanted to non-lethal him.
Well... He is holding a quite a nice staff, though. Looks like a staff... It looks like... It's a staff with a... Like a well-made metal spider on top of it.
Ooh.
Galen.
Staff.
Those guys can handle the spider. Yeah, they can.
You gonna give Thorin a potion?
I'm going to spend my whole round administering a potion to him.
Okay. 7. Thorin, you regain 7 HP.
I need to check something.
Sorry. Yeah, Thorin, you regain it. 0-7 again. Why do you keep doing that? It's your turn. It's half your speed to stand up. So 20 foot. And then you have 20 foot left. So you can re-engage an attack if you wish.
Yeah, I wish.
Okay, please do then.
Only I lost where we are. I have it again.
This one isn't hard to find. It's the top left. Okay.
We only have the spider left, right?
Looks like it. You hear that the other one is fleeing via the stream?
Yeah, first things first.
First things first.
What's up with people coming back from being a KO and then critting like crazy?
New feature.
Well, think about it. I mean, I do it, and I do it twice in a row.
It's second wind.
Nada. The spider is flailing about, attempting to bite at any and all of you, but it's kind of panicked, being surrounded and almost dead.
Finish it off.
I'll give it a tranquilizer.
And with tranquilizer you mean... Yeah.
Yeah.
Sylvania?
How far can I move in with a withdraw?
30 feet.
Yeah, 30 feet. The action is to withdraw and then...
35, you mean?
The action allows you to move your speed and then you still have your movement.
What?
Okay, so 35.
Actually, I don't know. Wait, let me check.
Is withdraw a thing in 5e? I thought it was disengage.
Disengage, withdraw, the same thing.
Well, you don't get your movement when you disengage.
Let me check real quick.
Otherwise, I would have been doing it completely different.
See, under action. 192. Yeah. You're right, it does not give you extra movement. Sylvania! So you have 35 feet.
That's fine.
Of course, you also could have just KO'd the spider and you would still have 35 feet of movement.
I don't know if I would have KO'd it though.
Well, that's a risk you
need
to take.
I mean, they can KO it. It doesn't matter at all.
So you're going to pursue the black spider, right? Exceptional. I think you have one first level spell left. That's it.
They have three attacks.
Yeah, I'm just gonna Ray of Frost it though.
Okay. That's cool.
Oh!
Galen. Oh, exceptional, you have movement. If you wish.
Nah, I'm not worried about it. I'll just stay there for now.
Okay, Dylan.
Where's my sheet? There's my sheet. Stab! Sneak attack!
And you down it. You still
have... Bonus action, run.
You're going to follow Sylvania? Okay, what are you going to do now?
Chase after it.
Okay.
If she's going, I'm going. Fuck it.
Okay, make your movement. Torin, make your movement. Torin, make your movement.
Alpha, wake up.
You can move twice, because you don't have an action to take. Nada, make your movement. I'm not reminding you twice. You know what I just said, right? Sylvania.
Okay, so... How far is run?
70 in total.
I need to know something before I can do my next turn.
You still... That's...
Five.
Exceptional.
There we go.
You have double your movement, please take it. Kaelin.
It's something that I kind of wanted to know. I can take run as a bonus action. Can I still not convert my standard into one?
I don't see why not.
So that's 90 then.
Yeah.
Go ahead, I'll do my 90 feet of movement.
I just want to know where you end up.
Okay. And then this is... Wait. This is 65. And I still have... 20 feet of movement.
Oh.
I can land here. This should be 95 because I'm... No.
Remember, no. That's difficult terrain.
Difficult terrain, yeah. Here.
But... You managed to chase him. You, I'm going to stop combat now. That was just to see if you could follow the trail. By using a move, by moving 30, then using an action to move another 30, and then using a bonus action that she can take to move another 30. And that's 90, actually, not 95.
So is that only something a rogue can do?
That's only something a rogue
action.
Can do. But you still cannot see him, but you can hear him, and he's just ahead of you. But he is keeping up. He is not outpacing you, but you're just barely keeping up. I'm assuming that you're just going to follow him until he...
runs out of...
Okay.
Yeah.
Well... Eventually, you follow him all the way to the outside. It's the wrong layer.
I mean, can I fire him?
Kaelin, you are the first to arrive. You are actually, you actually have a few rounds red head start. I'll say two rounds before the rest even gets here.
A fucking flash, that's what I am.
Yeah, but I have 10 feet more movement.
Okay, it's first scale in the rise, then two rounds later, Torin and Nadar will arrive, and then a round later, Sylvania and Exceptional will arrive. That's about how it adds up after that time.
That's kind of the thing, Sylvania is 35, so Nadar and Exceptional should be slower than Torin and Sylvania.
Yeah, I'm 30.
Oh.
Yeah, indeed.
I thought you were 40. Who was 40?
Torin is 40. That's because he's a monk.
I have 40 feet speed, so I can...
Okay, you arrive in the order that you can see. And just as you arrive outside, Kaelin, you... Well, not... Just before you turn the last corner, you hear... And that's when you turn the corner and you see... That
Oh, I was going to say we didn't get to kill him, but...
Well,
kudos.
Someone did. And now they see you.
Oh, fuck.
Thorin, you are not here yet. Wait, let me,
Well, this is going to be difficult.
Yep.
Well, I'm not going to be able to heal you, Galen, because I will be out of breath when I arrive.
Well, I won't meet because I'm just moving on my more normal speed.
I'm assuming that you're not... that you're actually, you know, attempting to follow, because that would be silly. Give me a perception check, Kellen.
Okay.
I'm going to give you the advantage of... I need to get my...
It's a 10.
Advantage.
No, you don't get it. That's not what I meant with advantage. Usually it's versus passive, which in this case would actually have been better. So I'll just say passive. Where is my... Trow. Elf's Trow. 126. There's one, rushes you from the side, Galen.
Dash actions.
And he rushes straight at you with his scimitar.
Yeah, you're going to die.
And it takes 6 Oops. Damage.
Nice knowing you, Galen.
6 damage.
Yeah, if you go down now, they're gonna coup de grace you the next turn.
We'll see.
Takes out a bow, a crossbow, and manages to miss somehow. And this one fires a greenish light out of the staff she's holding, and it attempts to strike you.
Come on, miss.
Wow.
How much HP do you have left, Galen?
One. I'm literally on the brink.
stabby.
Oh my god. I didn't see that one.
No, you didn't. The one in the bag, she is cruelly laughing like, you will sell for a good price. Sorry, wrong button. Oh, wow.
Well, in all those spy movies, the timer always stops at 1 second, so why not 1 HP?
And then there comes a crossbow bolt.
Good night.
Wait. Oh yeah, that bitch has to let a turn.
This one.
Yeah. It's always to let a
that
turn.
That art looks so different from the rest of the art.
I know, they're all different, like.
That one looks 3D.
It's hard to find good drow art.
You accidentally used 3D art without realizing it?
No, that's actually not 3D. That's just shittily drawn. Anyway,
you're right.
You feel a very strong poison go through your veins. Well, I would say make a constitution save, but it's safe for half. And it's not one that can be rolled. The minimum that can be rolled is 2.
Really?
Yeah, it's 2d8. No, sorry, 2d6. So, yeah.
So
the lights go out for you. But you don't die. Like, you just feel yourself fall to the floor, your eye is still open, completely paralyzed. And this one you can hear her. And she's also talking in Elven, by the way, which is the reason why you can understand her. She goes, "Beggar boys!" Okay, next time you will be here.
Well, shouldn't there be a huge back where Kaelin was?
How many times has Kaelin gone down?
She is stable this time.
Yeah.
Actually, you're going to be held behind.
Well, it's the third time that she goes that she
went
down.
I was about to say.
It just comes to show that you should only play role-playing games on your lucky day.
Which is never for me.
We'll have to like this. Torin! Together with Sylvania, you come across the corner. You see several drow holding an unconscious Kaelin.
Did they notice me yet?
Oh yeah, definitely. You are
so
running.
It's too
here.
Late to just run away.
Oh, they will pursue.
Which means that you would run towards us and they would pursue you towards us.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty good idea.
Okay, I'm gonna need some more map.
Right now it's 4 against 2, so I think I just run back. Into the cave.
Okay.
Yeah, it only works if Sylvania does the same.
Well,
yeah, I expect she follows my example since I'm first.
Pick a potion while you run.
Yeah, I pick a potion while I run. I only do one movement and I take a potion.
Well, then you won't meet up in the middle. If you take a potion, you're not going to meet up in the middle.
It's...
It has 40 feet of movement that would actually cover
it'll,
it.
It'll get you out of range, though, of them. Mm-hmm. And then you'll be able to meet up in the middle after that.
Okay, so you are not here. Okay. Well, Sylvania, you definitely are.
Hi.
Oh, it's payday today. First we killed it.
We were just passing through. First, you know.
Yeah, we were just passing through as well, but you not for long. They say
I'm just gonna go back now.
Nah. How about you don't? Shoots an arrow at you. And you can see it fly straight towards you. And it is dripping quite... fun. You take 8 damage, Sylvania, and please give me a constitution save. This save actually works specially. You manage to not fall unconscious. Of the poison that courses through you. Exceptional! You are not here yet. Sylvania, you still haven't had a turn, unfortunately.
Okay, so I'm going to head back towards everybody.
It's not your turn yet. It's not your turn yet.
Huh?
Invisible. Well, not invisible. Stealthy. Where do you think you're going? Love.
I'm gonna have a conversation with Linus.
Stab! You take 9 damage?
Well, fingers crossed.
Okay, I'm going to use a fairy. This plus 2, so I take no damage.
Okay. Now it's your turn.
Can I withdraw and drink a potion, or no?
Nope. And if you withdraw, you can only get 30
feet. Make sure you meet up with us.
You're not a rogue.
Okay, you're going to withdraw, but that only leads you 35 away. So you're gonna get shot in the back. Well, they're going to pursue.
If there's corners somewhere on there, I might be fine.
And not quite so soon. Yeah, give me a second. I didn't really think about this. Actually...
I think our movement speeds really made it hard on you.
Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
That.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So move yourself, your speed to the right. Imagine there's a cave there, okay?
Is there any corners directly inside of the cave, though? Or is
it's
like a long hallway?
It's a smooth hallway for a while. After about 100 feet, it turns. And you can see Exceptional and Torin and Nadar running towards you already.
So, okay. Where are the walls?
Yeah, let me draw some walls.
Wait, one moment before you end my turn, please. Look up something really quick that could be game-breaking.
So I drew the walls.
I'm going to take an action surge and take another movement action to... Wait, where is everybody? Why is everybody ahead of me?
Yeah, that's a good question. We don't know.
You should still be at the left side of the map. Ah. You are
so
going
we're
to meet
behind
up...
behind the drow and Kaelin?
No, this is where you are. Like, you are going to be there
the
on
map.
Your... You'll see what I mean. That is correct. Like, that's where you're
going
to meet
to...
up.
I'm going to...
Well, wait a minute. We were one turn behind them, right?
Yes, and they just ran
so
back.
So we should actually be where Sylvania is right now.
No, because she's using double movements in one direction and a single movement in the other direction. Anyway, it does not really matter.
Taking an action surge.
Okay, so you have another 35.
I'm action surging over here.
Okay.
And then that's it.
Well, they're going to go in pursuit. Whoa. I need to snap to grid.
Am I not
allowed
to drink while moving?
Oh, wait, that means that I got an action to prepare, right?
Ocean.
If you use an action... Actually... range. Oh, that's out of range. Nah, we'll just have to pursue. Okay. This distance... Oh, actually. I mean... Yeah, Torin. Whew, that was a good thing that I had.
An excellent spot for breath weapons.
You think that I had advantage.
What happened?
You're getting shot in the back with a poisoned arrow. You take 6 damage and you're going to give me a constitution save.
I'm gonna use deflect arrows.
Okay, you take no damage.
I'm gonna use deflect arrow.
Okay, you can take less damage or no, I forget.
No, that's not how it works here.
Okay.
I reduce the damage by 9,
okay.
So I can catch the arrow and I throw it back at him with my by spending a key.
Okay. Yeah, that's misses. But nice try, though. And now you need to make a no, you don't need to.
Yeah, if I hit him, he would have needed to make a constitution check.
Leave her there! She can, she'll be out for a while. Oh, wait, not 60. That's a miss. Okay. Torin.
Yeah, I think I'm still gonna move towards the rest of my party. So we can charge in all together.
Sylvania, You take 9 damage and give me a constitution save. Lekker. Exceptional. You have met up with the others.
I can see the opponents down there.
Okay, Kaelin, I'm going to move you out of the way because there's no real way they can save you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
It actually works.
Okay, exceptional.
I said I can see them, right? The opponents?
Mm-hmm. Ooh. So which one?
The one that would be on the our left in front of us, I guess.
Well, they're all of that. They're all to your left.
Well, no, I meant like if we're facing them, the front one on the left.
Okay, yeah. So the this one.
Yes.
Valiant fight. This one does nothing. Sylvania. It seems he...
Okay, I'd like to make an...
They seem to be planning something.
That as I was moving, I was able to withdraw a potion from my backpack
as
the rules with the interacting with objects around you.
But it's still going to be an action to drink it.
And then...
That's how it works. That's...
It says over here in the... that I could actually drink all of the ale in the flagon as an interaction with an object.
I'll let it slide for now. But don't expect this to work every time.
Okay. Alright. I will heal for a shitty amount. And cry like a baby. And, just kind of move over to here. And then that'll be... Oh, wait. Yeah, that'll be my turn.
Okay.
Yeah, just use the big giant lizard as a shield.
But you guys have HP, so...
This one,
Isn't that what big giant lizards are for? No.
The priestess on front starts chanting something, and then she disappears. Along with one of the warriors that was standing next to her. Like, but it's different. She disappears in a dark glow, and... Well, you almost feel relieved. Until suddenly... Shoop.
Oh my fucking god.
And then his ready action triggers. Oh, you're so lucky.
I would like to use a riposte.
Okay.
Who is meleeing me?
The warrior, of course.
This one?
Yeah, actually, this is how it's... No, this is how it's going to be set up. This wall is badly drawn. It stands with...
Elven light blade, please hit.
Nope.
That's the end of my reaction.
This one is going to walk 30 feet forward. You're going to shoot at Torren. Who takes 7 damage, perhaps? I think you do, because you already used it this turn.
No, I will use deflect arrows again.
Okay, let's see if you take any damage. You don't take any damage.
I take no damage at all.
Okay.
And you don't throw it back this time?
I also throw it back this time, that's a good point. See if I can give them a dose of their own poison.
Is that a thing?
Yeah, of course. It's the poisoned arrow. But, let's see. You don't hit. Just barely, actually. And their constitution saves are not that good.
Yeah, that would have been epic.
This one is planning something with the priestess. Nadar.
Well, I make a step closer and well, then I'm gonna jog his jaw out of alignment.
Okay.
And out of alignment it is!
It is indeed out of alignment! And he's going...
That's some nice damage.
Ooh. Ah, you are going to suffer before we sell you.
I grin and I say, it's a bet.
She steps down. And, well, you can guess what happens, right?
He explodes because she miscast the spell.
And this one swings his sword at you. Well, her very oversized dagger at you. And manages to miss again. Oh, sorry. Torin, your turn.
Well, you seem to do great with the archer. Why don't you face off against her?
Yeah, but if I go in melee range, then she won't shoot any arrows anymore, so...
Well,
I'm just gonna face off against her, that's a good point.
This would be the ideal.
I go stand in her face and I start hitting.
Okay.
Hopefully with more success and throwing back arrows.
Mm-hmm. No.
Damn, I suck.
They are concentrating on you one at a time, it seems. As he aims at your back. Sylvania. Take 9 damage. And...
Fuck him down.
Yeah, but it's not lethal. You don't start bleeding.
I don't...
It's the poison that starts working on you. And you feel... You drop to the ground again, your eyes still open, and you can only watch.
Wait, does the potion automatically succeed? Not that it matters.
It doesn't matter, I'm just telling a story at this point.
Okay, just flavor.
Exceptional.
Come on, guys.
Is Nadar's weapon magical at all?
No.
Nope, not yet.
I think I'm going to use magic weapon on him then. Or on his weapon.
What does that do exactly?
Plus one, I'm assuming.
It says you touch a non-magical weapon until the spell ends. That weapon becomes a magic weapon with a +1 bonus to attack rolls and damage rolls.
Okay, well, yeah.
It is a concentration spell, though.
Exceptional. You also need to take a 5-foot step away from me.
That doesn't exist in this system, but anyway. Do your turn.
Yeah, but he does need to make some distance for what I'm going to do next.
What, die? Because this one raises his scimitars.
That also works.
And he's going to attack twice, actually. Against you, Nadar.
Oh. That means I gotta kill him.
Right. 18 damage, and please give me a please give me a constitution save. Ooh. Yeah. Again. Clonk. Onto the floor. Exceptional. You see this happen right in front of you.
Yeah, not much I can do.
Yeah, now we're definitely going to die, guys.
Well, you're not dead. You're
paralyzed. Three of us out, two of us left.
But you're not paralyzed. You're just paralyzed. Start chanting something. And out of her hand, like, she holds her hands together and then she blows and there's like an entire swarm of insects that start swarming towards you, Exceptional. They sting like hell. Give me a constitution save. You managed to save it, so you're going to take half of this. Sixteen.
Okay, Exceptional. If you can, give me a healing potion.
This one has also had enough of your shit, Torin. So it's going to go full ham on you as well with its long swords. Ten damage. Constitution save, please.
Does anybody have the feeling that
matter.
Does anybody have the feeling that we're not supposed to win this?
Yeah.
I mean, I knew ahead of time we weren't supposed to win this, but
you still tried.
I knew it was coming.
Yeah, pretty much.
And I think if I
you
if
take
we could just
five...
focus fire this guy instead of splitting up, I think we could have like done something.
You maybe could have downed one, but anyway. Torin, you don't go on... Well, you're not at zero, but... You do feel yourself go completely numb and fall to the floor. And this one, he just... takes a step forward. And gives you...
And kills me.
A backhand. Splat against your face. I don't even know. That's actually... that's 1 plus strength damage, actually. That's 3 damage. So, splat. He just backhands you.
Yeah, that's exactly the HP
down.
I have left.
But they did say something about fetching a good prize, if you remember. Right?
True enough.
Yes.
Well, you can count your lucky stars that they were not a raiding party. They were here for some nice slaves.
I guess they didn't like dwarven slaves.
Well, they were also here for the Black Spider, who they did. Well, at first sight it looks like he was dead, but you can't really tell. You were too busy getting unconscious yourself. And eventually
well, if our
they just
six as soon as we're being sold, we know.
you remember vague parts about being going in and out of consciousness and being dragged onto, just dragged towards a cave somewhere. And then the next time you regain consciousness, you feel you are in a completely dark tunnel system. And you don't know how much time has passed, but eventually you find yourself in a room with several others. You don't quite wake up at the same time.
Galen would wake up first.
Everyone give me a constitution save. Actually, everyone who wishes to keep their character.
Vanya is tougher than that. Is Zypher here, by the way?
He is.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay. And you kind of had a bit of an intermission there because you got taken out first.
I know. I was listening. Just muted so that I couldn't...
Well... Sylvanian Exceptional, you kind of wake up at the same time. And you see several others around you, including a few of... your friends. You do notice that,
I'm gonna smack them awake.
You do notice that Kaelin is not there. And that, the Black Spider is in the same cell with you. Also still unconscious. Along with many others. And then you get a good look around, but that's for next session. So yeah, you were not indeed meant to win that fight.
But what if, what if would you do if RNG let us win it?
I kind of made sure that it wouldn't. Like, it could theoretically, but not realistically. Now...
Well, sometimes theoretical is all you need.
For next session...
Hey,
I want you to level up to level 4 just here on roll 20, and I want you to have this done before Monday. No later than that. So I want you to level to level 4 before Monday. If you want to play a new character, you need to let me know. If you want to re-roll your entire character but keep the same person, keep the same portrait, race, gender, and personality, that's fine. And just change the stats if you don't really like your build. That's also okay, you can do all of that. Or you can take an entirely new character. The one thing though is you will start with absolutely no gear. What does this mean for you, Exceptional? You will only have access to the spells that you have prepared at the moment. The ones that you do not have prepared, you simply don't have because your spellbook is gone.